Welcome back. Here we are, playing some Go. It's been quite a while. I think I still remember how the pieces move. But without further ado, let's see if we can get a game going. Sure, let's play a 9x9. Here we go. That was a nice little fade out there. So, yeah, apparently, I don't know. Like, I haven't played 9x9 in quite some time, so I'm not entirely sure where we're going with this. Obviously this game does get quite tactical, for sure. All right, here we go. Wait, I would call that an invasion, but let's try this instead. Yeah, basically, I am the target audience for this game. A Go beginner who's trying to not suck so much and have some fun doing it. I think I'm the target audience, I'm pretty sure. So, I'm a bit confused by this. Azwish. So, yeah. Already, I am entirely, completely befuddled, perplexed, bamboozled. Here, let's connect my stones. And assert some strength somewhere. I don't know, like here? That's called like a shoulder hit, maybe? I don't know. So he's cornering my dude in the middle. I do like keeping his forces separated, so I'm gonna keep that partition there. I'm gonna keep these connected and hopefully be able to form some sort of life down here. Not sure what he's getting at with that. Unless he wants to build up some strength on the other side, but... Jeez! He's good. And fast. I did not expect this, to be honest. He wants to connect on top. I don't think I have to allow this connection. I could try to do something more aggressive and try to kill this entire group. I think that might be a little too optimistic. Also, I could try to kill this group down here. Just diagonally slice the board. I'm not sure if I can successfully kill all that. Yeah, it's true. I did not read far enough. Also, I just have no idea where to look while reading on 9x9 boards. You're absolutely right, though. I did not read far enough. Now, can I just do the same kind of thing down here? Like, I don't know. Like, surely... I just feel like... And you shouldn't play Go based on emotion, I guess. I'm just trying to get back in the hang of this. And apparently failing badly at doing so. So I guess I allowed him some strength there. He gets to kill my two. But I don't know. Wait, what? Can't I just kill him now? Like, I'm pretty sure he didn't read this outright. Or this is just a race that I'm totally lost in. But what are the odds? 1, 2, 3, 4. You should read before placing your stones, by the way. So this is really poor form on my part. No race. Oh, wait. I have 1, 2, th- two and a half, three, four-ish liberties. And if I connect, I've got even more. So liberty isn't really a problem for me here. Territory might be a problem because he's definitely invading, but liberty is not the issue. I mean, yeah, this group is dead. I want to play this and force into place there, but I also kind of want to cut here and see what happens. And I don't know. Like, this does help get me toward the corner, but then he places at 2-2. And then I have to extend out and he kills me. So that doesn't quite work. Let's see. I could try to threaten stuff over here, but I don't feel optimistic at all about that, and that cuts into my own liberties. Yeah, connecting's not sente. Wait, if I go here, he spends a move, I go there and then kill him. I never understood these co things. Like, do I want to play there and then extend, or do I want to play here first? I feel like this gets sente somehow. I don't know how to read this sort of situation. Why not live? Okay, so what I played was unnecessary. I think now I don't know, I still have options. I'm definitely making this closer than it needs to be, though. So what am I supposed to do? One, two, three, four, five? I need to. Yeah, I'm not even sure what's going on here. I'm trying to read and failing abysmally at it. Because, like, unlike all the training problems I do, this isn't just like a two-move combination. This is much longer than that. Okay. We got four liberties here, giving myself some more. Kill that. And I could fill in this and then kill here. For sure, I'm destroying my own territory and it's disgusting. I don't like it. Yeah, no, he took a critical point there. He's completely won this, I think. I don't know. Like, there's no weak points for me to cut at anymore. I'll try to invade from this direction, but it's not going to work. One, two. Oh, shit. Okay, force him to kill that, and then once he fills. Oh, shoot, no, that. So I'm threatening this group of two. I'm trying to do a throw-in to kill this entire group. The only reason I'm moving so quickly here is because I'm down to my last. Well, I forgot about how Byo-Yomi works, too. So now I'm threatening to kill both of these stones. He's gonna fill in this liberty here. So I'm still alive. Now I get to kill this one step at a time with a single liberty to spare. But yeah, this was anything but efficient. Oh my goodness. I have to kill this and let him kill my one stone there. I could dig in this way. He kills me, and then I kill back here. I don't see any other defects to go after. I mean, I could play way up here, but there's no point. Actually, this doesn't even expand my territory. Oh, wow. That's a bigger move than I was looking at. So I have to fix this before he starts killing everything. This is just a prisoner, it's not alive. Why did I do that? It's because I'm bad at Go. So, yeah, now he fills there. Now I still get to kill this, but there's no point. I'm not increasing my territory any. And he's got no defects, so. I could fill my territory to prevent him from killing that, but so he fills. I think it's still. I mean, this is stupid. This is something I should know. But filling a territory to prevent losing a stone plus a territory is worth it, I think. I think I'm still lost here by a very large margin, but I think that move is worth it. Yeah, he passes, I pass. I could just resign here, really. Yeah, white wins by 7.5. So I've completely failed to cover. Well, I think Komi's 5.5. And beyond that, my territory was just no good. So, yeah, he captured 10. I captured 16, apparently. Yeah, I don't know what's up with the territory scoring. I think the margin, though, at the top of the screen is based on what the OGS server tells you, as opposed to some local analysis. But, like, let's count this. 9, 3, 1, 4, 2, and 2. Just 9, 10, 13, 17, 19, 21. This is nowhere close to 21 in terms of territory. But yeah, in terms of captures, apparently, yeah, I don't know. Let me count my territory here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So I'm n 9 territory less, I think. So, I mean, I'm confused because I'm counting that I'm down 9 territory. The game's telling me I did 16 captures to White's 10. I'm not sure how the math adds up here. I did kill a very large group here. I don't remember suffering similarly, so probably the scoring of the number of captures is off. But yeah. I completely failed to cover Comey. I guess I'll look at this link you provided, although I'm not able to get it. I have my chat window on a separate device than my streaming device, so I'm not able to show this on stream. Let me take a look at it though. Okay, so I could have just gone for the upper right corner. Okay, I was right that he could have lived if he had played H2. Oh. And your first variation, let me back up to this. Because this just shows a complete lack of Go understanding. Like, I can solve tons and tons of problems, but unless I retain that information, what's the point? So at this point, the F1 group down here is dead. So, yeah, I could just play like up here, force that. This is what initially I was considering too, and then this just lives for black. And so this group is dead, and then I could try to invade over here. It's a good go concept. I don't know why I thought these two stones on the right were dead-ish, but no, it's just completely wrong. As for scoring, I mean, I still don't like black's position. But this is better, substantially, than what I had in the game. Also, this thing where I walked into this weird co thing on the left and on the right, completely unnecessary. The F1 group is entirely dead. There's no need to kill it. It's just dead. I mean, that's all territory for me. So, I don't know. Maybe this could have worked. Anyway, I'm finding that the 19 by 19 games are kind of interesting too. So let's create a new game. We'll start this with 300 seconds. Five Byo-Yomi of 1 minute. Oh, winning by far. Yeah, I'm not very good at counting, in case people can't tell, but on the large boards, there's so much territory. Usually, when you're playing against somebody, then one player is substantially better than the other. Sure, let's play a ranked game. Why not? Interesting, we could pick a rule set, but we'll pick American rules. Let's see if this goes anywhere. Let's see, can I. It doesn't allow me to see before the game, like, where can I drop the stones. Man, that looks cool. I'm surprised you can zoom in that far. So. Yeah, we'll see if this GameSeek finds an opponent or not. You would think that counting on a smaller board would be easier, but I don't know, it's difficult to identify territory in such a dense area. If this fails to find somebody, maybe I'll take a look back at the lobby, see if there I can find a seek there. If not, I might just go on the OGS page and take a break from this ancient Go and just play using a browser. So, Yeah, so far no takers on that. Let me fire up the browser over here and see what's going on OGS at the moment. Oh, do I have some custom user style or something? How come I can't see the main menu? Wait, did that fix my main menu issue? Okay, that's cool. Let's see, can I find a game out there? Oh. Apparently there's only one other Seek out there that's not accepted yet. It's on a 9x9 board again, so I guess that's what we're gonna go do. Main menu. Wayneology. Here we go. If I can click the damn button. Did that work? Oops. Well, this is more like what we were looking for in the first place. 19Q. Can we join this one? Of course we can't. Sure. Let's try this again. Well, let's say 10 minutes plus a bajillion 60-second yo-yo-me. I don't know why it's not letting me click on the ads. Living is better than racing. Okay, that's a good thing to know. Filling in your own territory in a race. Yeah, I've started to learn this, that if you're filling in your own territory, and especially if you're filling in your own liberties in a race, that's bad. Oh, standard is more like 10 minutes plus 5 30-second yo-yo-me. Okay, well, I suppose we could give that a wait. Did I get an opponent? Why does it think that I have an opponent? Like, 18Q is my opponent. I don't know. That was weird. Yeah, apparently I've borked this. Let's go on to the web page and try it that way. We'll just have to do without the lovely graphics and sound and so forth. Let me sign in and we'll continue where we left off. Okay. Window capture. Window capture, please. There we go. Much better. Let's try this. Play a game. Am I in the middle of any games, by the way? Apparently not. So, yeah. Short games, long games. 3 days plus 1 day up to a week. Yeah, let's do one of those right now. Now, yeah, I could keep the sound going. Does anybody like the sound? It'd be a nice thing, I think. Let's see. 19 by 19. 20 seconds plus 10, up to 30. Oh, is that an increment? That could be silly and fun, and I don't know, given this hour, maybe that's one of the things we want to do. It's a ranked friendly match. Sure, why not? Oh, Fisher clock. Increments by 10 seconds per move. That sounds fun. All right. Good luck. Here we go. Toggle them coordinates. Holy moly. I don't even know. There we go. Corner number two is mine. Tanuki is probably ridiculous there. Or whatever the term is that applies to the thing I'm doing. Wait, can I go Zen mode? Yeah. Wait to move. Oh, I can't see the timer here. Well, all that matters is if I'm below 10 seconds. I don't care otherwise. Four corners, I win. Now I just need to play Tengen. Okay, that is Tanuki. I was thinking Tanuki was like the suit you have in Mario 3. And that might also be Tanuki. Okay. You want this corner so badly? Fine. That one's yours. I'll take this one. Okay. I'll take this side of the board. I don't know what this is. He's building up something in the center. Okay. I don't know. Okay, two space extension, three space extension, something. Sure. Lawn dart go. Yeah, that seems apt. Okay, he got one of my stones, guys. What should I do? Should I panic? Here, we'll take that side. Yeah, he definitely got that stone. Good for him. Oh, hell no. Oh no. No, you don't. All right, so. Oh, that's Atari.
Ten.
I have a feeling I should run.
Ten.
We're gonna run, guys. I'm not too sad about losing that stone because I feel like I have an enormous advantage this game. And I might even be killing this monstrosity of a thing here, too.
10, 9, 8.
This is so bad. Oh, yeah, well, I mean, the situation could have been much, much better than it is. I don't dispute that. I just think it's okay.
Ten, nine, eight, seven.
Like, there's no way he's gonna surround me. Could have been 100 times better than it is, but I think it's still good.
Ten, nine, eight.
Oh, my group here is super, super, ultra, mega dead. Oh, shit. Yeah, I misread that.
10, 9.
Okay. Point taken. There's actually some threats here. If my opponent were any good, he would see said threats, and I would be in deep trouble. I've got to take this more seriously. Oh my goodness. I'm so bad. Wow. Why am I so bad? I should be reading, but I'm so excited about playing Go. It does help that my opponent is 20Q. But I can imagine all of you cringing watching this. So do I connect here, or is this stone not, that stone's not saveable. So
10, 9.
Let's run and keep running. This is almost some sort of kind of invasion, maybe. Yeah, he's building up a wall here, but at the same time, I don't think a stick is a living shape. Okay, you cut. Oh, I can't cut him back, because then he kills me. So I force him to fix his defect. I've pushed into his territory and reduced it, and I need to be content with that. Or, plan B, he's 20Q. We just have some fun with him. Okay, that's Atari, so let's fix the Atari. Okay, that's also Atari. Probably not an Atari I need to worry about. I don't know. This is definitely a double-digit Q game. That's a useful stone for me, so we'll keep it. He persists in trying to surround me. To what end, I do not know.
10, 9.
Yeah. Person keeps counting down. That's distracting. Alright. Atari. Atari. Black wins. Is there Chessmaster like Go software? I think the best client that I've heard of is called Leela, L-E-E-L-A, in terms of a free client. I hear it's strong, I hear it's good for analysis, but it doesn't have the full like automation in terms of the Chessmaster recommends knight to F3. Knight to F3 develops your knight off the, yeah. It doesn't have that sort of thing for Leela. That sort of thing doesn't exist yet. I don't think there is anything quite at the level of Chessmaster. There's some analysis engines that are quite strong that are commercially available, but I don't know that I would consider that training software. It's actually hard to use that to analyze positions. Did not know that. I played a couple games on it, like, forever ago. Okay, that was Lawn Dart Go. I don't know that we're going to learn much by analyzing that, other than Well, I did play some bad moves. So fine. Apparently, I will analyze Lawn Dart Go. Actually, we could take a look at the silly opening. I probably am supposed to. I don't know. What do I do against a 5-3 hit on move one? I don't know. Like, I could play the other corner, the d4 here. This is just a really awkward to meet first move. Just descend. R16. Okay. Get the. Oh! Okay. Right, because, like, if he tries to put up a fight, I can do this, or I could play S15. Likely he's not going to go for that sort of thing, but would instead probably extend this way. Or extend outward. Yeah, I don't know. There's probably all kinds of shapes that could be made here. Like, I'm not concerned about this, because that doesn't threaten to move into the corner, I don't think. Whereas this tries to threaten to do something, and I'm not totally sure how to meet that, but it's pretty slow. I could do this, but what's the point? Anyway. Go back to the game. It's good to know I can descend though. Like even here I could still descend and the corner's mine. And I can make some sort of living shape out here and he's gotten some territory. But I just took all the corners. At this point, after this, didn't really know what was going on. Protecting here is probably useful, but claiming the corner, I don't know if that works with him having put the stone at 0-15. Like, he's got more stones here than I do, after something like that. Or Q17, or I don't know. This is why I should have defended it earlier. Yeah, he's neglecting anything you would typically see. It's exciting, but, yeah. Okay, I probably shouldn't analyze that too deeply then. Let's see if we can find another game. Nine by nine. 10 minutes. Okay, we have. Yeah, here's. Apparently, they call it a short game. Oh, holy. Look, another Fisher Time game. Yeah, let's do Fisher Time on a large board. That sounds fun. Good luck. Okay, there we go. And Tengen is taken. Okay. Is this the same dude? Am I just being obtuse somehow? Okay. Ha! Didn't see that come. Oh, he did. Never mind. Okay. Sure, let's fight. Why not? This is silly. Guard the corner. Fix the defect. Guard the other corner. Man, this got violent. Okay, can I kill anything here? I mean, I should be reading as I play. No, I can't immediately kill stuff. That's too optimistic.
Ten, nine,
He did succeed in confusing me, so I'll give him that. Okay, so he gets a stone. I take the corner. Okay. I'm kind of panicking because he's playing like instantaneously. Alright, so this is the big plan to not die there. Is this called a net? Oh, that's Atari. Damn it. You think I'd be better at recognizing Atari by now? Do I go ahead and kill these two, or... No, those are... Yeah, I do have to kill them. They're not dead. Like, if I go here, he... I don't know. This seems like a saner thing to do than... Oh my goodness, I'm so dense. I thought I could just kill this. That's not Atari. I'm being dense. Forgive me. and he does form a ladder. So I'm gonna keep trying to run. Yeah, I'm being incredibly dense today. It's been a long day. I don't want to complain on stream because this is a fun game. Yeah, I still win the opening, despite playing like a total moron here, but I hate it. The opening is mine. So I've built up a wall. Building a wall. Building walls like there's no tomorrow. I don't understand how many eyes there are here. Like, there's... That's not an eye.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6.
Let's build this wall and then take some kind of extension here.
10, 9.
So much for forming an extension out here. Still take this corner. I don't know. I'm panicking over the time because, like, anytime I click a move, he instantaneously replies. And that's, I guess to some extent I'm doing the same thing, so I can't complain too much. Also, I'm trying something different in this corner. Mostly for the sake of just seeing what happens if I try different things. So I'm a double-digit Q player, like way down there. This is like my 10th or 11th day playing Go. I have everything in the world to learn and nothing to lose by playing this. Oh. Okay, right. So he does kill my stone. He does have eyes down here. Sorry if I'm a bit distracted. Up to four player go. Wow, how about that? Did not know that was a thing. Oh, I'm an Atari down here. That's not good. Can I run? Probably not. Yeah, I am in deep doo-doo.
Ten,
So
nine, eight, seven.
I don't know what to make of any of this. Oh, if he plays. Yeah, and if I play here. Now he's got. That's not an I. So I do succeed in stopping him from taking that corner. This thing, he's trying to surround my stick. I'll keep him cut. I guess I run? Running seems decent. Ay. He insists on fighting. It's not even a fight he can win. Like, say what you will about all my other screw-ups, but I'm actually winning this particular fight, I think. Oh, it's a self Atari. Well, that was no good. I'm just ticked off. I apologize.
Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one.
Yeah, I'm not finding a move. Thanks for the game. Okay. Can defend this way. Okay, so that's good to know. That does prevent him from connecting. It's a good defensive move. This would just be a ladder here. Oh. Wait, what? Okay. Yeah, apparently I don't know how things connect. Easy variation. Yeah, so obviously I don't know all these corner formation things. Can also just connect with Sente, keeping the two shapes separated, keeping my guys not dead. Yeah. There were numerous opportunities for improvement based on just having even the most basic of ideas of how to address common situations. Like here. Yeah, I don't know how to deal with these 3-3 corner invasions. And he did a 3-3 corner invasion at every corner, and every corner I tried something different. And the only one where I didn't end up dying was the upper right corner. And that upper right corner, I lived quite pathetically. So I still have quite a bit to learn about 3-3 invasions. But yeah, also, I think it distracted me that he was playing all these interesting moves at the beginning. Rather than giving me an outright like handicap, like you would in a handicap game, he elected to play these interesting starting moves. And it just really caught me by surprise and put me perhaps in the wrong mindset. I've not had any success against this kind of formation either, so confidence was not necessarily there. Let's see if I can create a game. 19 by 19. Sure, we'll pick a live game. Maybe I should put the music back on if I could get the app back open. So, apparently Steam needs to update itself. That'll be there momentarily. Okay, let's get the game up and going. Let's see, apparently this Seek isn't finding anyone. Should we watch a game? Might that be more entertaining? Here's a 2Q. Wait, no, can I watch the game though? Can I see a game if I click on, I don't know. Okay, here's a Seek. 9x9, 17Q. Sure. Challenge has not exist. Bummer. Let me turn the music up a touch. Yeah, and the funny thing about this is, I'm still a beginner at the game. I really don't have the right to be ticked off when things don't go well. So I did notice they have a link up here too that says ladders, but that doesn't refer to Go ladders. That refers to like a ladder in which you play Go. It'd be kind of fun if there were just a book or a set of puzzles all about ladders. I feel like that would be the sort of thing I could eventually learn. All right. Let's accept this if it's still there. I'm gonna say good luck and hopefully play okay. Oh my goodness, I forgot. We were playing on a 9x9 board. And Tengen is pretty damn popular on move one. Well, okay, so I just made life way more interesting for myself by playing the way I did. Let's go into Zen mode. Fundamentals of Go. There's a chapter devoted to ladders, and it's a classic. Well, that sounds fun. All right, do I thread the needle, guys? Or do I go on the other side? Yeah, let's go on the other side. See what happens. So, probably bamboozled my opponent as much as myself. If I pick a fight here, I'm probably losing this. I could continue the fight off this way. So I think the best move is probably e7. Supporting his little thing there. Okay, that's Atari, so I don't want to ignore that. I just think that if you, like, play c7, then I'm starting to build up some solidity here. I could be imagining things. Like, I could be imagining this isn't a ladder. I don't know. I could also just take the weak point here. Because he's building up... I don't know, it seems like I can't save those two. I'm being ridiculously impatient tonight, and you'll have to forgive me for it. So I lose 2 stones. Or he connects here. I didn't think he would do that. So, yeah, my plan is not quite working out because he's connecting his stones. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm not going to kill any of this. Right. I have to remember my place here. That's an empty triangle right there. I actually can Hane right there, too. Okay, well, Hane at the head of 3 stones instead of 2. And see if we can reduce this corner a bit. And then try to take... I don't know what. Oh! There goes another stone. Okay, I guess we get to reduce the corner this way then. Hopefully I'm not dead up here. First line moves are sad. Let's connect. I could have supported this back on E2 instead of F2. This seems like a larger move than fighting down in the lower right. Although possibly the largest move is just C3. So I'm confused. Like, if I place next to a stone, I make it stronger, but at the same time, I can't let him extend here forever. I'm so perplexed. I like 9x9 games are not the most predictable because there's fighting everywhere. But I think this fights for the largest side of the board. So this is a fight worth doing. Maybe H7 also. If I do that, he takes an Atari, so I'll do this instead. Now he does take my stone. Now do I Atari and then J7? That seems like a wasted move. Do I connect and threaten to go B9? Do I just play C9? I think I fix here. This protects the largest corner. Even though I have a weakness at D8. Right. If I go there, I'm an Atari again. So we go here instead. He kills that. Oh, I don't self Atari. What am I thinking? I'm playing too impulsively. The music is calming a bit. It's just not nearly effectual enough to offset my sad play. Yeah, if he'd played D9 already, he would have a real threat here, I think. And then I would have to connect at F7. But the way we're playing this, I don't have to do that. That's interesting. So, yeah, he can do these things with Sente, and that's pretty impressive. Can I invade? What can I do here? Is he threatening to invade? I mean, I shouldn't even have to ask that, because that upper right corner very much looks like mine. I'm concerned that he might try to throw in an H9. No, there's like a million ways I can make two eyes there. I shouldn't have to worry about that. So, yeah, we'll stop him from going A4 by playing A4 ourselves. And then we start filling dame, because what else can we do? I don't know, E5 would have been worth. It's like I play a move, and then I find a better one. But only in trying to explain things, but. Okay, so I get the lower left corner. This fills a shared liberty. It's scary. That doesn't gain either player anything. This doesn't either. No, actually, filling this forces him to fill in one of his territories, so that does gain me something. But yeah, I don't think I'm anywhere near being winning this. Okay, that was unexpected. Am I forced to react to it? I want to say yes, that everything must be immediately responded to. Moreover, I want to say I'm nervous about him filling in, I don't know where. Okay. I have not kept track of number of captures. He's captured 4, I've captured 0. So between that and Comey, I'm dead lost. It's just a question of how dead lost, dead lost. I'm starting to think that first line, that C1 move, was inaccurate and B2 would have been better. Okay, so that's Atari. I'm forced to connect. Okay. This would be not self Atari. If I kill here, mean that looks like two eyes to me. Let's give this.
Ten,
Oh,
nine,
seriously?
eight, seven, six, five,
I got five
four,
yo-yo-me here.
three, two, one.
Okay, so if I kill that, I could always connect here. Unless he plays there and I have to go here, and yeah, that's disgusting. If I play h8,
Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four.
yeah, that looks like a living shape to me. Anyway, that particular position and my thoughts about it gives you some insight as to the thought and the mindset of this particular Go player. And by that I mean me. If you see me struggling with something like that, it just gives you some insight again into, like, I'm not, like, the Garry Kasparov of Go. Just saying. Yeah. That's kind of why I figured why I'm streaming this, is because I figure, you know, even if I'm completely flummoxed by it, other people might enjoy it. Hopefully over time I don't suck this bad, and actually improve at the game, but yeah, that's the other thing is, I've seen a few of those videos and it's amazing how, conceptual some of those are. And then variations trail off with, oh yeah, and then just play this and you're winning. And I'm like, oh, okay, if you say so. Alright, so the next question to me here is, am I forced to play F9? I'm pretty sure the answer is yes. Nah, the answer is definitely yes. I've solved enough Go problems to know this one. So I wonder why he's playing on. Like, I thought he had this in the bag, but I could start to count territory and prisoners here. On the other hand, not everything's resolved yet. Also, that's been hanging there forever, and I've not tried to exploit it. So that's cool. So let's push. Okay. I can push again. I don't know that I have any tricks here. How many Byo-Yomi we got?
One.
We got 4 Byo-Yomi left. Yeah, now I see, like, I've lost a liberty here. So, I do have to seriously consider these plays. Actually playing there. Yeah, that's annoying.
10, 9, 8.
If he plays here,
6, 5,
I kill that.
4.
If he plays down here, I mean, yeah, I get I have to be careful, but I'm just flat out not seeing it, and that's something different. I think that's just general advice.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4.
This is a move of extreme caution that loses a territory that just didn't need to be played, period. But, I don't know. Like, there's no way that... I just can't read. It was necessary. Huh. But... I don't know. I can't read. I'm bad at reading. I can only worsen my position by continuing to play. I mean, I could play this. Let's see if he comes up with a good response to it.
8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2.
There we go, guys. That's Atari. You think you'll see it? Oh, he saw it. I don't know. I got nothing, guys. Wait. Oh my god. I'm an idiot.
10, 9.
Okay. You didn't see any of that. You got that? Wow. Okay. Well. Okay, he passed. I guess we can pass. Auto score. Yeah, sure. There we go. Accept the removed stones. White wins. He shouldn't have responded to... Yeah, right. Right. No, I get that. Nobody saw that, though. He still won. Okay. You can save them. Oh. Yeah. Oh my goodness. Look at that. The double Atari. Two mistakes were C1 and E1. Yeah, C1 was terrible. I should have played B2. E1 was a mistake. Somehow. In some variation. So I can save them. G6 isn't necessary. Getting territory is better. Whatever this means. It means something. I don't know. Like, I suppose there's like a zillion ways to get territory. Like here probably gets territory. Here. 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 Somewhere. These probably all get territory somehow. Why don't I use X's? X's are pretty common. Yeah, I think that could have gained territory. G6 was unambitious. Yeah, I'm just playing where my big clump of stones is, because it's safe to play there, which is not how you play Go. Oh. Wait, what? Oh, did I? Wait, how did this proceed in the... Oh. Okay, so I can allow two, just play three. Right, and I've got strength here. That makes a lot of sense. That makes way too much sense. Oh, so I should have gone for this. Yeah, in hindsight, H7 would have been very good. I like the shape a lot better. Because now I get the upper right corner. I mean, yeah, I'm inviting him to kill my stone right away, but it's just... I get so much space for it. It's beautiful. Yeah, and he should have played H7 too. Because I've already given them the strength to go off of. Yeah, B1 is better. So I didn't react to this invasion very well. Yeah, so... Oh, wow. Yeah, so that forces me to fill on B1. Nightshade only move? Right, I did find this only move, so at least I calculated one thing correctly this game. Yeah, E1 resolves all the tension. I think ultimately ended up being necessary because otherwise he plays E1 and I'm forced to react somehow anyway, and this is just the best way to control everything. Yeah, eventually I'm forced to play B1. E1 was bad. Oh, that was a misclick. Yeah, I think you're meaning to say that B1 is where I should be playing anyway. Because he's going to eventually play A5, and I will be an Atari. Which I completely missed during the game, in case it wasn't obvious. Yeah, since he's going to play A5, I should just play B1 and kill these stones. G9 didn't work. Yeah, this stone up here was misplaced. Oh, down here. Okay, so yeah. Right, so... Oh yeah, I guess I did have to... Well... Now if he plays down there, I do have a move. How do I place stones here? I've got this move. So I'm actually okay, and E1 apparently wasn't needed. So I win the post-mortem. Hooray! Yeah, clearly B2 would have been better than C1. Obviously, at the end of the game, there is this big move that, thankfully, my opponent missed. That would have been sad. But I would have still lost by half a point, had I not sucked. But whatever. Actually, I lost by 1.5. I didn't make any mistakes after killing these, so... Yeah, E1 was not necessary. Killing these invaders was necessary. I've not had very much experience killing an invasion. I think that could be a fun thing to do. Most Go problems are like, find the thing that immediately kills this, as opposed to, your opponent's invaded, find a reasonable defense. Yeah, if I did not play E1 and C1, I could have won by half a point. That was... it's respectable, I want to say. Let's play some more Go. Sure, let's look for a 9x9. Yeah. Yeah, there should be things like, does this require another move? Okay, this is weird. I'm gonna attack. Maybe. What kind of weakness is this here? I guess he's trying to limit my territory or something. I don't know. He's trying to just crush me in the middle of the board. So I guess we made like a smiley face or something. So there's that. Really? Is this really a good idea for black? Like, I played b5 with the expectation that there's absolutely no way he's gonna play c5. And he played it anyway. So, we'll see if I'm right. Okay. That's maybe a thing. Wait. What do we got here? That would be a self Atari. Don't want to do that. I'd rather, much rather do things over here. So this, h2, d2, this feels right. I'm not sure why. I want to see it. Oh, this is just Atari-ing myself on both ends. Never mind. Somehow I thought I'd just advance with d2 next and everything would be okay. That's not how it works. Okay, he's building something up here. I'd prefer to keep his stones disconnected. He should just connect on top there, but, let's see, do I connect here or do I connect here? Let's connect here. Okay. If I'm counting liberties right, I'm doing fine here. Now, I mean, I could, like, ladder-ish this. I thought we learned our lesson last game that playing first line moves is bad. But I'm worried that if I play here, he'll play j6 and connect. I'm worried about what? h8, j6. J7, no, I can't do J7 there. H6, J6, H5. Does he have some way to connect down here? 1, 2, Atari, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. No, he doesn't make it. So I can do this. He plays J6, I have to deal with the Atari. At least I think I do. Okay, if I do this, I think I'm okay. So if I do why would I do that? J8 seems more rational, but I don't know. Wait, is this entire shape just dead? Like, is this something I not even need to worry about? If he connects and he plays this, yeah, I'm just way ahead on that race. It's not even a race. It's gonna come back and kill me later, but as of now, I'm still okay. D6, J5, connect. Yeah, he gets out if I'm careless. J8's not a terrible move and it prevents him from deucing me, but there's stronger moves here too. I play this and he plays J5. This is just all sad, basically. I'm gonna play this so he doesn't reduce me. That's my excuse, even though really it's just to prevent any kind of tactical embarrassment. Oh. Speaking of tactical embarrassments, he got out. So, if I go there, he connects. It kills me. Could play this. Could play the corner. Either way, I'm fighting over really small areas. Well, we'll see how this goes. Right, so now I'm an Atari. I have to take care of the Atari. Okay, do I have to respond to this? I really want to play E8. I don't know if it's necessary. I mean, if I completely neglect this area, it's gonna suck, but I don't know if E8 itself is necessary. Let me dull the music a bit. And by that I mean quit that music, because I'm sure people are getting tired of that. I'm not, but it does get a little bit overwhelming after a while. But yeah, F8. How do I meet this? Yeah, if I just ignore it, it gets worse. So we'll address it. Also, how am I doing on time? I'm down to half a minute versus his 8 minutes. But we got 5 Yoyomi, so that's okay. If I connect... wait, what if I go here?
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 2.
So that's Atari.
Two, one.
Let's deal with the Atari. Okay, game has ended. White wins by resignation. Alright, so we have some comments on the game. Should try killing this. Oh, wait, what happened there? Oh, I accidentally double clicked something. Should try killing this dude. I have the strength to do it. I'm not. Interesting. So I guess. Yeah, I've successfully cut him off from the left. I can cut him off from this side as well. And then he could try to descend, but he's got nowhere to go. So, I've received a new friend request. Sure, why not? Okay. Scroll this down. Black is in trouble. J5. At some point in the game. Oh, here, J5. Oh. This would have been pretty bad. Wait, why three there? Two, three here. What about three here? Oh, my three are in danger. My triangle's in danger. So this makes more sense, so I don't lose a triangle. I just lose two stones. Then I have to connect here to avoid losing more. What did I play? How did I avoid this? Oh, I threatened that immediately. Black went here anyway. Wait, how is my triangle not dead? Oh, because he's an Atari if he does that. So he gets out of the Atari. I reintroduce the Atari. Even though I'm not really thinking about these three, what I played ended up saving them. But, you know, J8 looks wrong. This just saves the three outright. Let's see if this was commented on at any point. This looks bad. Yep. I don't know if black went... Yeah, I don't know how that all turns out. That gets messy. Wow, that gets so messy. Okay, variation 8. Black might live in the... Wow, that's intense stuff, guys. That's seriously intense. Yeah, no, I think this, though. This seems a lot more straightforward. Unless I'm missing something tragic, but... I was so obsessed trying to kill these five. And, like, say he does this and he tries to connect. Yeah, I got an okay result. I think I could have done a lot better, though. Like, I guess that's the best I could have hoped for. He still gets out. Is there no outright kill? Oh, I'm sorry, I'm back in my own variation. Yeah, I guess I didn't realize how weak I was. Okay, so let's back up a bit. Did I ever miss something here? 'Cause I don't know. It's like, how did this play out? He plays there. I could play here. He extends. I don't know. Like, I just feel like I had more than I had, than I ended up with. Okay, so I guess you guys are convincing me I actually played this okay. I can still kill the upper left, which is huge, because I have strength at the end of this. I wonder. So he plays here. No, that is a good play by him. Yeah. I think this is better than F7. Oh, right! So, yeah, I should protect my weak stone, which is this one here. Yeah. You probably should still do something like this. I'm doing okay here, I guess. Well, no, I don't want to do it that way. Yeah, I don't know what to do against two. Like, I'm playing decent moves to build up strength, but I'm kind of ignoring my weakness here. This is complicated, isn't it? No, I don't know about that four. Yeah. Anyway, this is 9x9. Their 9x9 games are notorious for being tactical. So I'm sure tactics can fly all day and all night there. Wouldn't it be funny if this were the best move? You know, if just saying, you know what? That's great. You placed a stone there. I'm just going to extend, increase my liberties, and if black still somehow dies here. That's just wishful thinking on my part, but all right. Yeah, have a good night. Wait, how did I even get here? Is the real question to be asking. Like H6. I played H6 because, well, I guess that does try to support my triangle, but more importantly, I just didn't have any idea where to go. This could have been cool. Yeah. Oh, but what if I don't want one or the other? What if I want to kill both sides? I mean, this looks fun. I've created so much chaos here. Even H4 is just unnecessary. Yeah. Like, this whole thing could have been avoided. I just play here. Even better, just play here. And, black is severely divided. I don't know, black connects here, I guess. And stuff happens. Although with, I mean, one is an attack right here. Oh. Okay. So it's not just a matter that this is a bad thing, that he's just separated. It's a matter of we're playing 9x9. You cannot afford to do this kind of thing where you're divided in all four corners of the board like this. As in, white is completely, totally winning here. Not just, white has a small advantage. Still have to be careful about F4. Like, at some point, this could be an idea. Like something like that could happen. And yeah, suddenly I'm surrounded somehow, but it's unreasonable to expect more than two groups to live. Okay. Yeah, if this were to happen, I wonder. I am so curious where this would go next. Oops, not there. This is where I was aiming. I don't know. Stuff happens. I get the corner. Yeah, it's a different game. Okay, variation. I think this is good. Okay, so yeah. I guess my play out here at H6 was reasonable after all. And there were good follow-ups to be had. Even after this 2 move, I can try to push this way, extend this way, and yeah, I guess black has kind of an issue in this corner. Yeah, that's pretty awesome. Not gonna lie. The fact that 3 happens with Sente is really nice. And black, actually, yeah, that is with Sente, not just any Sente, but just Atari. Oh, 2 is a bad move. So, is 2 something black doesn't want to do? It feels like black wants to do this, he just can't get away with it. Like, this might be something black could do. But I guess e8 is something you just can't afford there. Giving up the d6 stone's okay for black. Okay. Yeah, trying to save everything. Oh. Okay, so that's an overplay. That's a good word for something you'd like to do, but doesn't work out in practice. It's overplay. So let me go back to this variation, back up a few moves. So yeah, this is an overplay because white's not getting surrounded here. Like you pointed out. Now, if you're trying to save the D6 group, you have to do this, and D6 group is still in a whole bucket of trouble here. And even if D6 group does survive, white gets so much for it. So that makes sense. I was concerned about 2, because, like, you've seen in the previous games, my opponents would invade, and just everything would go terribly. Exactly. Like, I'm sure that some of my opponents are getting away with things, and I'm just not even seeing that. And that's really what I'm more concerned about. And that's why I'm playing these, like, at least in the post-mortem, I'm seeing these ridiculous moves like e8, and I'm like, okay, well, what would happen if I were to do that? Yeah. Like, I feel that most attacking moves, or half of them I see at this double-digit Q level, by my opponents are overplays. You remember the one game where my opponent did a 3-3 invasion in every corner? I'm pretty sure that's considered an overplay. Not in the same sense as this, but it's still not ideal to be doing a 3-3 invasion when you have nothing to support it. But it's tricky. It's a good thought exercise. Yeah, I religiously do sume go. When you have like a four move combination that wins the entire game, I can do those. I'm less good at knowing when to just keep throwing stones at a position and when to Tanuki, which is kind of big. Oh, somebody's putting a Sika out there. A 10Q. Well, it's a 13 by 13 game. Not feeling up to that. Yeah, let's put a 19 by 19 out there again. But it's just silly. Like, if you've ever seen a chess book, actually, I think I've seen a chess book that's like 300 mate in one puzzles. It's great. Sure, if you know how to checkmate in one, that's a useful chess skill. It's not the only skill in chess, but it's a useful one to know. Actually, yeah, there's a book like 303 Tricky Checkmates, and they're all like mate in one or mate in two. Silly, silly puzzles. There's like, if you go to any library, you'll find all these books about here's how you checkmate with a queen, here's how you checkmate with two rooks, here's how you checkmate with one rook. And it's great that they have all these resources, but learning that, having that kind of training in Go where find the one move which instantly wins the game is just silly. Yeah, it'll come up in games, but there's more to Go than just finding those moves. Here, let's play this. Let's say good luck. All right, here we go. All right, no cross game this time. 4-4. Yeah, knowing life and death is a useful thing. All right, we approach. He approaches. We panic. Here, let's approach this way. And I don't know. A quadruple 4-4 game is confusing. Okay, so we got all the corners going on at the same time. Here, we've created an imbalance. Now the skill is figuring out what's the largest side of the board and what do I do about it? They all look pretty even to me. Something. Something. All right. This is a two space extension. This looks big-ish. Okay. He's invading my corner-ish, maybe. Okay. What's the biggest side of the board now? Okay, let's build another base, maybe? I feel like this is somewhat urgent, though. I can't just ignore that. I could play 5-5 just to confuse the bejesus out of everything, but no. Where am I? Oh, I could also like play out here somewhere. Yeah, what is this? What am I looking at? Why don't I try to invade this corner and then build up strength and kill this? How do I even approach that? I just don't know what's going on. I think he could live here if I tried to kill this, though, or he could run. Like, I can't stop him from running. It's too early to do that sort of thing. I'm so confused. Let's play the star point. Let's be a star. Okay. Well, that was short-lived. Okay. I just don't know where to fight over. I feel like the bottom side of the board is large. Actually, the right side is pretty large too, so let's take that. I was not expecting him to go C11. And I feel the C11 is urgent, I just don't know how to respond to it. So he's building upward. I'm not sure why. Let's build a base here. Okay. Let's invade the corner. So he builds a wall, I build a wall, we all build a wall. So now what? Like, I don't have anything out here to build a base from. I could play this to, like, try to deny some bases or reduce them or something. I just don't know. There's another hit. All the corners are on fire, which is pretty cool. Wait, can I build up something here? I'm so confused. Okay. Let's see where he goes. Maybe self Atari. Yeah, I don't know. Certainly the rules are not so hard to learn. The scoring is a bit tricky at first. Again, that'd be self Atari. I don't want to play there. I don't know if he's living in this corner or not. If I play here, no, maybe. I'm so confused. I can't connect both on top and underneath. So the stone might be lost to the ages here. The rest of this, however, is looking decent. I should have extended just to see how far. No, that wouldn't do anything. Never mind. so we prevent him from connecting directly. And we invade down here. And this time, don't orphan the stone. Wait. Okay, that's quite annoying. He's cut me in two. How dare he? Oh, okay. Yeah. Leechess is still deployed. Not understanding what your question is about what happened to the Leechess project. It's still a real project. Are you asking, like, about the Flick Chess variant? I'm just finding that incredibly difficult at the moment. So, is he trying to kill my dudes? Did I even have to do that? That seemed silly. So what's going on here? We're building some walls. I'm trying to surround territory. And we're fighting over probably not a very large area. I mean, I'm getting this right side of the board, but I'm giving him a wall toward the center. So, let's try to move in on the corner. He's got to defend there. And I think that's enough of that area for now. Oh, the win on... Oh, right. Yeah, no, I'm still thinking about test positions for that. I still need to come up with how am I going to test that. And make sure I haven't broken anything. Okay. Apparently we're getting feisty here.
Ten.
Oh look, I'm in Byo-Yomi already.
Ten. Nine. Eight. Seven. Six. Five. Five, four, three, two, one, ten, nine.
Oh, Yo-Yomi are 10 seconds apiece.
Nine, eight, seven, six.
That's bad news.
Ten, nine. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. 10, 9, 8.
Today I learned that 10 second Byo-Yomi is not very forgiving.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 10. 9, 10.
Particularly when your opponent
ten, nine,
is super interested in trying to push you over on the clock.
10, 9. Ten, nine, ten, nine, ten, nine, ten, nine.
So I did force a defect in that wall.
Nine, eight, seven, six, five.
I get the sense that I'm not winning this game.
10, 9.
Beyond just being in severe time trouble.
10, 9, 8.
Seven, shit.
6, 5, 4, 3. 10, 9. 10, 9, 8, 7. 10, 9, 8. 10, 9.
Does this kill this?
10, 9.
No,
eight,
not even close.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
That was stupid.
10, 9. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. 10, 9, 8, 7. 10, 9.
Oops.
Eight, 7.
That's so not forgiving. Let me turn the volume down. Oops. Yeah, we'll just concede this. Alright, well, that was so distracting. Yeah. The goal of the game, yeah, what's apparently that's what 10-second Byo-Yomi is like. Contact plays against an unsupported stone are probably worth responding to in general. Yeah, right. This usually goes like this. So, okay, usually you do build up some strength in the corner. Same with shoulder hits. Yeah, and white usually is able to respond with this later. And so black builds up some solidity on the outside. Yeah. Right. It's easy to get scared and respond instantly. Particularly when the voice just keeps talking and talking. And 10 is such a loud number, too. But it's definitely there to get your attention. So, okay. Apparently that's what 10-second Byo-Yomi is like. I am nowhere near ready for it. That's for people who've played this considerably more than I have. But also, just having what was going on all four corners of the board was pretty confusing, too. So that was an interesting experience. I certainly spent all the time on my clock. But, yeah, what can you do? So, let's see, how long have we been going for? Go for a little bit longer. And then maybe after that, I don't know. Here, let's do some puzzles. Something to cool down a little bit with. I've already done most of these. Let's see. I don't think I got through Stone Development for Beginners. I got, like, here or something. Okay, this is the basic form of the knight. Here's a standard cut for the knight. So this does cut them. White will have to respond out here. You might think that white can capture this in a ladder. And you're right. Presently, there's no problem for white, since white can capture black's cutting stone in a ladder. But you should know that there's potential trouble for white. Depending on the surrounding position, the weakness in this connectivity could cause issues. Yeah, suppose that depends on the surrounding position. I don't know how instructive that is. Here's a more realistic case to show the weak connectivity of the night and the trouble it brings. Okay. This is a basic corner pattern. You can see that the stone marked black and white represents the form of the knight under threat that was from the last example. Presently, there's no serious problem for black. If white cuts this knight, black can capture the cutting stone as we saw before, but if white adds another threatening stone, there could be a problem. Okay, so if white threatens with a knight's move from the knight, white's got stuff that he can do. For example, white can... Oh, that does get serious. Interesting. Yeah, I think that's instructive. Let's see if we can use that in a game, maybe. Or maybe I'll just seek another 9x9. These have been fun. Actually, let's do 9x9 in Fisher time. Yeah, maybe after I get used to Fisher time, maybe it'd be worth going back to Byo-Yomi. But I just find the whole concept of Byo-Yomi really distracting. And not only that, but I've not played chess in Byo-Yomi before. Maybe I should do that sometime if I have the option. That could be an interesting time control. Like, I've played chess with an increment. I played it with a delay. But Byo-Yomi sounds interesting, because then you're not worried about how much time is left on the clock. You're not in some hurry to make a move in order to preserve time for future moves. You get an opportunity to think about each move for the same amount of time. Apparently I'm not going to get a game this way. Can I at least look at a game? Let's watch a game. Alright, here... okay, black's in time trouble. Yeah, white to move. See, this looks so much saner than what we were looking at a moment ago. Because black, I mean, there's not weaknesses everywhere. This looks a bit too sane, though. Also, I'm kind of curious, like, this tension on the left. Is black running? Is he safely running out of there? Is he sacrificing those stones to build up some crazy moyo? I don't think he is, not on purpose, but... yeah, it looks like black... he needs to find a way to make some eyes. Does he have eye space in the center? And if he does, is white going to take a lot of territory? This looks really weird to me. I have no idea what to make of any of this. So... white fixes a defect. Black connects underneath. White tries to prevent a connection. And black could extend all the way. They could keep going along the S column. And as a result, white would keep going along the R column, and white builds up kind of a wall there. Oh. Okay, so white builds up a little bit of strength with that move. I assume if black pushes, white would Hane. Yeah, this move here, this R13, leaves me confused because it seems like black's not connecting. I mean, the race has certainly begun here. One sec, I'm gonna hit the washroom and be right back. Alright, so what's transpired here? Black has taken a corner. White has built up one hell of a wall. They're starting to build some kind of shell in the center. And it looks like black looks extremely disconnected to me. I've got to look. Like, what are the player's strengths here? So white is 3 Don. Black is 1 Q. So 3 Don seems to be winning against 1 Q. But this level, this game is honestly beyond my level. So I'm not going to understand the finer points of what happened here. Other than it looks like black is just super disconnected. They must be playing a pretty rapid game. Let's see if we can find another game to watch. Here's a 2Q and a 1 Don. A 1Q and a 1Q. Here's a game. Let's see, what would be fun to watch? This one looks interesting. This one, it looks like something's going on. So white's taking the upper right corner and the lower right corner and the bottom left corner and the upper left corner. So something's happening in this game, that's for sure. Yeah, this game's this looked interesting from a standpoint of there's a lot of pressure in the situation and one of the players is responding to it. Yeah, this does not look very balanced. Let's see, can we seek another game? Let's try the 19x19 again. Hang on, there's some more seeks that popped up. 21Q, 9x9. Let's give this a try. And say, good luck. Okay. Right, we'll try to connect and isolate this G7 stone. Okay. Is he gonna Hane right here? I wonder. Right. So I did. I think I joined a Fisher time control game, and I'm. Oh, you're saying be careful from the what perspective? I'm not afraid of losing on time. That's for sure. Only because I've played tons of chess games with a Fischer time control, so I know how that works, generally speaking. There's, in my opinion, a lot more time in a Fischer game than there is in a just a normal game. Oh, yeah, because I don't start with very much time. No, that's a good point. So he plays the 1 point. Do I dig myself in? I really want to do this.
10.
I'm going to do it just because I'm curious where it goes. Not because I've read it out. Right, so. It's Atari. Oh shit. I'm stupid. Okay, so I lost 3. I still get some territory for it, but. Yeah, it was bad on my part. I mean, it just shows, like, where my focus is today. It's not on the game. Okay. Hopefully I'm not losing my big group. That would be sad. I think I'm probably losing the game, though. Am I an Atari? Oh my god. Wow.
10, 9, 8, 7.
That's a bummer.
5.
I'm gonna pretend that didn't happen. Just gonna run with it, keep running, and then concede. That was sad. Oh my goodness. Wow. Oh, that was something. That was a thing. Okay. Oh man. I do not have the stamina for this, do I? Okay, so where did this go wrong? Other than everywhere. Specifically, I mean, yeah, my opponent read better than I did, and I'm just ridiculously fatigued, but I'm curious. Like, I don't know. What's going on here? He attacks me. How? Like, I'm just trying to connect my stones. He attacks me. I try to connect this way. He continues attacking. I connect. And for some reason, I feel compelled to go attack his weakest stone. Why did I do that? Like, at this point, I'm just completely bewildered as to what's going on. But, yeah, no. It's just amazing to me that this kind of approach is even, I don't know. This really caught me off guard. I guess the fact that I played my first two stones so far away from each other is something worth thinking about, but I'm so confused. That was impressive how he was so efficient at attacking me. Like, that's one hell of a wall. I am so confused. Okay, so he extends. I guess I'm supposed to connect right away, which I did. Now he connects underneath. And, like, I got this really ugly shape, and he's got this beautiful beginning of a wall. Like, how is that even possible? I never get that sort of thing, and he just did that semi-automatically. I was thinking if I play here, he just goes there, and I have, like, no chance at connecting. So, I don't think this is wrong. But this certainly makes me question what's going on. Do I have to connect here? I guess this is urgent. I have to do something. But I'm not too pleased with this result. I don't know. This is weird. I don't think what I did was wrong, but I just don't know how to follow this. Do I do this instead? I mean, now he cuts me. I can extend out, but I can do this. We have a cut here. This doesn't look any good. Yeah, I think if he plays there, I have to do something fairly urgent. And I just didn't. I think, well, maybe this is okay for white. Yeah, I don't know how to read this at all. G4 is super tactical here. I didn't expect to hit this early in the game. I still have no idea even where to begin reading this. I don't know, like, do I play F7? This kind of sort of contributes to that, but not really. This actually helps strengthen him a bit, and I have to connect here. And I don't know, that's okay. At least there I've got a wall, but he's not going to let me get away with that. No, I don't like that for him. So if he hits me, yeah, maybe F7's a good hit in return. I just don't understand. I mean, I could hit here too. But now these are disconnected unless I play there and he builds up, and I don't know. This is just unpleasant. Maybe I should go back to playing on a larger board. I don't know. I got a 19 by 19 with a 11 Q. Playing a super long game. Got a 9x9 with Fisher time? Oh, that's taken. Yeah, let me try one more large board game. See if I can find an opponent. See if I can play okay. It could just be, like, the reason I didn't leave my Seek hanging out, it flusters me that I see, like, four Seeks going on out there. Well, one of it's just mine, but I'm missing out on three other games by having my own Seek out there. And yet, I don't know. Like, the minute I start to go look at some of these, they're gone. And I can't even filter this to say, just show me the ones that I want. Which, I don't know exactly what I want, so I guess it's not such a big deal, but... yeah, we'll just put the Seek out there for 19x19 and hope somebody takes it. Although, I guess people are reticent to play against the noob. It's probably the deal. So, yeah, I guess, on the whole today, I did okay at identifying Ataris, even though I missed a few pretty grotesque mistakes. I haven't played the 9x9 board in a long time. I think I lost most of my 9x9 games today. I think I lost all of my 19x19 games today. I haven't played much Go lately. I don't know, maybe I should just reserve this sort of play for weekends where... I don't know, I'm trying to pick it up, playing it during the week here. And it just seems that I don't necessarily have the focus or energy to do it. Maybe I need to do this some other time. Okay, we got a game. Say good luck. So no cross game today. Here, let's play this point because we can. Now, I don't claim to know these Tsuji, but hopefully we can get something halfway reasonable out of this. Can I approach down here? And now what? Okay, I get pincered. Well, this would usually be the point where somebody... Maybe I run this way. I was gonna say I could try to, like, prevent him from building a base over there, but... now running toward the center seems appropriate. Okay. That's interesting. Because that does put influence in the area. Puts a stake in the ground, but it's not overcommittal. Right. Gosh, I don't want to invade. But I'm struggling to find another reasonable way to enter this corner. So that feels urgent. This R3. how to meet this. I don't know. Let's protect this corner. And then maybe build a large base out here somewhere. Okay, I don't know what that's about either. Like, does he want me to dive into this corner? It's not even about that. He wants the whole lower left side, and this threatens to threaten stuff. So I'm gonna play some weird stuff here. Really? He's gonna hit me. Okay, we'll hit back. I don't claim to understand this. I seriously do not claim to understand what's going on here. I would say 1, 2, 3 jump, but jumping seems scary. So much going on in this vicinity. So how do I get out of here? This seems like an overplay, but I just have no idea where to go. That just encourages him to keep building, doesn't it? I'm fewer on liberties than he is, so let's try to get something out of this. Is that a misplay? Evidently, no. He's not asking for a take back. Okay. Maybe I'm still surrounded here. I think I just lucked out. Okay. Well, that sure looks menacing. Hopefully that's an accidental net that works. A lot of my accidental ideas don't quite work. I should have read that out. I'm just horribly impatient tonight, as I've mentioned before. Somehow I still enjoy playing it. Even as blind as I'm playing here. Alright, so I have to play this. It's Atari, so we'll deal with the Atari. Okay. Well, that's one hell of a wall. On the bright side, I don't know. Something. Maybe I play out here so I don't get surrounded. Maybe I play on top of the wall. Because I'm feeling, I don't know, adventurous. What even makes sense here? Maybe I play down here and try to kill some stones and just take the corner and give up the lower left corner. I do want to save these two stones if I can, because they're going to be useful for eventually trying to take this corner. But I just don't know. Oh, hang on. I forgot there's another side of the board. Yeah, we'll take this side. That's a large play. It's probably not as large as the lower left corner, but... okay, that does prevent a two-space extension. So we'll play a reduction here. We got really caught up in this little fight that was going on. And then there's more of the game to be played. Okay, what the heck? Why is he building up like that? Well, first of all, can I live? I don't know if I can live. If I go here, he goes there. I go here. I don't know. We'll try to live. This might cost me 3 stones and the entire lower left corner. If he plays f8, I'm failing to read this. But I thought I might be okay here. Right, so he cuts there. Now I Atari, and then try to connect out. Actually, I don't need to play this right away. Do I? I don't know. If I don't, he might cut here, and it gets... Yeah, I can't kill him in time. So I have to try to extend my way out of this. I'm going to make some attempt to connect all my stuff together so he doesn't get the entire left side of the board. So that's the hope. Faihane, I don't know. Just something. Like, why would I even hunt it here? It's not like I have other stones in the vicinity there. So here is me connecting. Now, what is that? Like, do I need to connect like this? It probably behooves me to do this. I don't want to cross cut here. I'm just going to connect. And then try to connect down the left side and across and just live. And if D17 goes, oh well. But at least I'll have reduced this black monstrosity here. I don't know what's up with her counting. It seems irregular somehow. So he's got three liberties. What? What is this? I guess I'm forced to connect? So we connect. He's building up a huge center influence, though, so I can't ignore that. I've got three liberties. So, yeah. We just kill this pocket. I think he misread that. My opponent is 21Q, so I shouldn't disregard that possibility that he misreads things. Okay. So, I guess we're gonna fight again. Like, I don't want him to connect the left to the right, because that prevents me from connecting. F18 might have been a wasted move. Just based on misreading a possible race. Well, misread would imply that I'm reading now, wouldn't it? So, good gravy. So if I hear he goes there, this is like basically Solfatari if I go there. Let's fix this defect. Since I don't want to be further sliced into pieces. But now, just like this whole situation feels super uncomfortable because I have not found two eyes over here. Maybe D14 was the right play.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2.
I'm gonna fight. Keep these stones disconnected so I have some chance of killing stuff and living here. Or maybe I'm just moved toward the corner? I'm not sure. I feel like also I should try to push into this somehow more. Hope I'm not walking into something. But also, can I just net these? Especially after a move like that, can I just net this? Where would a net be formed? Do I have to hit to form a net? No, I don't. Let's go here. Maybe B9 was more appropriate. So I'm pretty sure 4 in a line do not live. So as long as I don't forget about Atari in some situation, I'll be okay here. I'm sorry, that timer's getting to me. Oh, have I forgotten about an Atari already? I'd like to think I haven't. Oh wait, I can just Atari him. Oh. I was thinking of that in a really defensive point of view, but yeah, now that he brings it up, I could just Atari him here. Or I could continue building this wall off to infinity, and it really doesn't give him any liberties to keep going. But before this gets too insane, let's stop the madness. Then connect this? I shouldn't have to. Yeah, wall off to infinity seems nice. Not gonna lie. Okay. So this is Atari here, just as a single stone. But seriously, if there is any capture race here, I'm totally winning it. Okay. White wins by resignation. Okay, cutting here immediately is good. Oh. Yeah, I completely missed that. Wow. Wow. Okay, so what was Black's last move? Oh. What did I do? I ran. I could have just cut. And this makes excellent use of my stone right there. Oh my goodness, I was worried about nothing. Okay, variation. Attack the lower left. Really? What did I do? I ran. Huh. I guess, like, if I look, I've got D10, E8, E7, F5, and F3. I've got all these stones bearing into this position. I've effectively up a stone or two or three over here. So yeah, I do have enough to support an invasion. Yeah, so if I just like play, I don't know, this seems, any of these two up here seems safe. These two here frighten me. The 3-3 and the 3-4. But yeah, I could be convinced that 3-3, 3-5, and 4-6 are decent invasions. This 3-4 point, I guess because I have the stone right here, it might be okay for me to invade right there. It just frightens me. At the very least, Black needs to respond. Ordinarily, when you're attacking a group, you need to keep both surrounding groups strong. Right, so he's trying to surround me on, we'll say, the up or the center side, and his bottom group here is really weak. 3-4 lets him live. It's a more peaceful approach. Huh. D3 is more about trying to make eyes. So if I like go here, my goal is just, I guess, to make some kind of eye down here. And Black can peacefully run away. He could also do this, which probably fails badly. Like, I don't know. This can't be any good for Black. But yeah. Hane, okay. So this would be a normal response. That seems reasonable. Yeah. And then white, I don't know. Like, Black has to build on the center side and on the corner side of this while he keeps trying to kill me. And he can't build on both sides at the same time. So I'm gonna get something out of this. It's unlikely that I'm gonna kill this black thing, but the other thing I don't understand, so attack the corner. Oh, right. So if I just keep building like what I did in the game, Black is in no way obligated to respond to this, even though he did. He could just protect the corner. And then this is sadder for me. So that's why I need to pounce on this opportunity. It's because it's not always going to be there. Yeah. So that would be a way to gain territory. Okay, so we got this variation going on here. Where what? He plays there. I play something. I Tanuki, I guess. He's threatening this. So three stones are lost if Tanuki happens. Well, in fact, even without Tanuki, I'm probably still screwed there. That's probably the point. I don't know. What happened in the game? Oh, no, I'm sorry. You're just saying, yeah. Yeah, so this F18 was in fact necessary. that otherwise I don't get to capture these stones. Okay. So I can feel a little bit better about that. Just that if I play some completely disregarding this area move, I don't get that capture. I could probably still play this though. This is probably even bigger. Or at least D18 is probably okay. Like, this is probably fine for white. Yeah, but locally I do need to do something. I'm curious, what about this? This is probably bad. Maybe not. Maybe not. I guess his position's so bad that I can afford to do a number of things here. Three, four, five. Yeah. So, yeah, maybe this is okay too. It's probably not the best move, because it kind of gives him sente, whereas this, I'm just fine. Like here, I have sente. There's this other thing. He's got sente, I guess. Or how's that all work? What I'm trying to say is he gets to play this with sente, and I don't know what else he's gonna do in this general vicinity, but sacrificing and playing R15 might be okay. Just in general, or just here. R15. Okay, so. Oh, you're saying for white? That even giving up the stones and just taking the corner might be better. This is an interesting way to protect the corner, too. It's a pretty big corner, not gonna lie. It just confuses me when, well, this is double digit Q, go. And we're playing like a 20 Q versus a 20 Q. Yeah, this is an enormous framework here. On the right, on the top, in the corner. It's a lot larger than this little pocket. Plus, it still takes time for black to actually go ahead and kill this stuff, so. White. I don't know. As long as white connects and doesn't give black the entire left edge or something stupid like that, white's probably doing pretty great. Oh, R15 really shuts down invasion possibilities. I guess, yeah, he can't build a base anywhere out here anymore, can he? I mean, now that I've played R9, R15 being a, instead of 5 space extension, 4 space, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, I can afford this kind of 5-space extension because he can't play a stone and then play a 2-space extension. So 5 is probably like the maximum here. R16 would be too far because then he could play a couple stones with a 2-space extension there. Prior to R15, S16 or S15 would be decent invasion points. It's not really even evadable. So, yeah. Regardless, I guess this is really good to know, though. Like, I had no idea just how solid this corner is. Or even what the approach points were. So, seeing some of that helps take a little bit of a surprise out of the game. So, yeah, I did manage to beat a 20Q. Maybe I should be proud of that. I did play. I did put a lot of effort into this. Even though I'm still bad. And even though this is semi-casual-ish, because I'm just tired. But, R15 is the typical way of defending that, with an enclosure around Q16, Q17. Okay. Should remember this. Oh, another point of order. This point in the game, I was thinking, what about this? Like, how far can I go? This is probably too far. Wait. If I go here, he has to do that. Then I can do this. This is probably as far as... Can I even take this further? Yeah, no, I guess that's totally fine. Now, these extra stones here aren't adding to my liberty count at all. So they're not making any of this... If a race breaks out, I don't know how. If one did, these wouldn't help toward the race. But these do help toward my territory and stuff. Okay. So, yeah, even though I cut this off a little bit early here... actually, a lot early. Yeah. Black shouldn't be pushing me like that, because that just means more territory for me. Okay. It's really good to hear that that doesn't gain Black anything whatsoever. Because I was thinking, well, surely, like, in Go, there's no such thing as getting something for nothing. But this is, like, the one situation in Go where that is, in fact, something for nothing. Alright. Yeah, best of luck with the dog and the thing. I have to be careful, because, yeah, sometimes... Like, okay, I guess the one thing he does get is that if I'm paying, like, no attention at all, and we just keep going, he gets this. But, yeah, if I pay at least the slightest bit of attention and play 7 here instead, then he doesn't get anything. Yeah. And such is the situation where... The opponent keeps putting themselves into this situation where Atari's going to happen. And I've done that before. I've, like, thrown stones after things that were already lost. And if you just keep adding stones to a dead shape, this happens. And not only do you lose the stones, you lose the territory that's behind those stones. And... I mean, in theory, this builds up some influence, and it all depends on the local situation and stuff, but having this influence is better than not having it. So, as long as I don't, like, just let Black escape, which would not surprise me if I did that. Would not surprise me at all, given how many things I missed tonight. Let's see. Well. Where are we at? Yeah, I think in terms of Go, we're still learning the game. Learning about enclosures and such and approach points. It's good to remember, good to know. I have actually seen this before now that I think about it. Even so, still good to know. But yeah. Man. Oh, that reminds me, there is a puzzle out there, It was something similar to this, but involved building a ladder that went all the way around the board. It was pretty cool. Oh, there's a video about the S-15 invasion. Like, he made a video also about the 3-3 invasion. Like this. I need to watch that again at some point. I did try to watch it and I just zoned out or something. I don't remember any of it. I think also I was distracted trying to code something. So, yeah. Yeah, I think that was a while ago. I'm making some progress. It's just a difficult game. I think at some point I do want to try to learn again. What was it? Shogi. I know that's not the most exciting thing for everybody here who's here for the go, but I do want to go back and do that at some point. Yeah. Imagine, they should make videos where, like, after the first 5 minutes, you have to play a move in order to access the next 5 minutes. If you play the wrong move, you have to watch the video all over again. That would engage the viewer. Or encourage cheating. I don't know. But, yeah. Yeah, I don't know. I've tried Shogi. I think eventually I'd get good at it. I think I'd probably get good at Crazy House faster than I get good at Shogi, because Shogi also features this balance between attack and defense. It's just that that's a balance you have to keep preserving throughout the entire game. Unlike in chess, where you can get away with some really heavy attacks or some really stubborn defenses in chess. In Shogi and in Go, you have to have this greater balance between offense and defense. So. Huh. I'll check that out. I've got a visitor in my apartment. Oh, that's unfortunate. By that I mean a pest. Oh well. So, yeah, tactics and Go. Yeah, it's amazing how, like, some tactics can compound themselves into much larger tactics. Or you can choose to divide up a tactic and just sacrifice some part of the board and then go for some territory elsewhere. So, I'm trying to remember. There's some point earlier in this game. Yeah, stuff happened here. Obviously, I didn't make the best use of my influence, and like was pointed out over here, I could just cut. And this just reduces everything to something much simpler. I'm actually kind of curious. The more I look at this, I don't know, like, you can't do that. This is kind of having to extend. And I don't know where this goes. Yeah, okay, I'm sorry. This is... Wait. I messed that up. Something like that. Ladder's the other way. Huh. Starts with 06. Oh, right. This way it happens. Yeah, well, that makes sense. Yeah, because this starts with an Atari. And is able to continue with Ataris. Yeah, that's a lot more sensible. No kidding. Okay. Yeah, I've. You know, Zug was saying at one point he's gonna make a book that my 60 favorite or 60 most memorable pawn captures. Somebody's gotta make such a book just about ladders. Or that has just like a ladder theme going throughout it, and like every tactic is decided in a way that involves a ladder. I know ladders can occur pretty frequently in Q games, probably even more possible in double-digit Q games, but less likely to actually occur because the players will miss it. I don't know. He had an amazing ladder in a game yesterday. Well, that's pretty cool. I just remember seeing one really famous game where a ladder connected with another ladder going diagonally across the board. And like the odds of something like that happening are so low. But it's so beautiful when it does happen. Oh yeah. Yeah, I guess that's true. You could have a ladder bounces off a stone, goes a different direction, and yeah. Yeah, the Li Cheng Ho ladder game. That's the most amusing use of a ladder. 'Cause who thinks of combining a ladder with another ladder? I mean, that like never happens. Oh, I'm sorry. No, that was Lee Sedol. Oh, wow. So what was the Li Cheng Ho? I know I recognize that name. I could have sworn that you were right. Anyhow, I'll have to look it up again sometime. It was a good game. It was a fun game. Anyhow, yeah, I think I'm making some progress a bit slowly tonight because just don't have exactly the same focus as I'd have other sessions where I've said I'll just sit down and play Go. Tonight, it's just more trying to throw stones on the board and see where they go and see how it happens. Yeah, certainly Li Cheng Ho is a very well-known, very strong professional player. I just thought I recognized the name for a special reason, but I don't remember why. Like, I've heard names of many top players and seen some games by them. And while, like, I'm learning a little, I don't know, you don't really teach a double-digit Q to go look at these top-level games. You might teach a Q player to go look at the top-player games, but for me, it doesn't yet make sense to do that. Other than just seeing, I don't know, the game for being a beautiful thing. And there's that too. But yeah, I have some of these more basic things to learn. Just gonna say though, yeah, I am gradually learning the game over time. I need to be patient. I need to learn what time controls kind of work for learning. And I think tonight we figured out that what was it? Oh, 10-second Byo-Yomi is something that I'm going to avoid for a very long time. 10-second increment I can maybe do. The 30-second Byo-Yomi is like all the rage and people love it and fine, more power to them. I still am, I don't know, I'm saying maybe if I could find some chess site where I could practice in Byo-Yomi, maybe I get more familiar with the time control. Yeah, I think looking at top games does give you this sense of like where top players would play, but it leaves me very confused when I watch a Sabiki video and then I try to emulate something and my opponent just deviates from the plan. And what do you do? It's good to have that sense, though, but I'm sure that'll be more useful as I get to a level where I'm not giving away Sente for free every turn. Yeah, they do tons of reading, and I think if I were to play slower games, then having that better sense of where would be a good place to play would be a good thing. Yeah, one of the reasons I don't commit actually be cool. In chess, there's the possibility of playing from a preset position or a preset series of moves. I wonder if there's a similar thing for Go, where they just give you, oh, here's a typical middle game position. We're on move 80. Go, just play. And I don't know, I think that could be actually pretty instructive. Although maybe not on a 19 by 19 board, I don't know. Maybe on a 13 by 13, but I don't know. I think it could be interesting just to have a preset position and have a beginner play another beginner on that. Go used to be played with a cross game on the 4-4. Well, that was the default start position. Man, that would be fun if you could actually set that as the start position, just so beginners don't have to learn this positional stuff. They could just, I don't know, attack all four corners at the same time. Oh no. What did Nightbot do? Tibetan Go. Let's take a look. Oh, check that out. Yeah, I'll have to take care of Nightbot. Let's see. I was on 17 by 17 grid, the fixed start position. All the stones are equally spaced, and white begins play. Okay. I guess that's interesting. There's plenty of opportunity. So, yeah, I'm sure something is happening here. Well, clearly the players like white just plays there, L11, black plays G11, and you just get this nice checkerboard. Oh, there's no snapback. Co-rule may not play a stone on an intersection where the opponent has just removed a stone. This does make snapback illegal. Oh, that's interesting. So, yeah. I am curious now. What would Go be like without snapbacks? There's so many variants that are possible. I'll have to try some at some point. Maybe I'll learn something from it. In any event, yeah, it's been a good session. Things have been learned. I've been rambling here for another 10, 15 minutes, but the discussion seems to keep going on. As people seem to like this discussion part, because I don't know, this is where we can have kind of a back and forth about just how the session went. As opposed to me saying, oh my goodness, look at the time. Look, I'm running out of my Byo-Yomi, and it's hard to have a serious discussion while I'm flipping out like that. So, it makes sense to have this little session, either beginning, end, middle, whatever. But yeah. Eventually I'll get a better hang of this. I should play this when I have the focus to play it, as opposed to just casually like this, because even though some things were learned, they were It's possible to learn a lot more with the same amount of energy if I'm just more focused to begin with. Hey, sup? We're ending soon. Sorry. Suppose I could bring up a game. We could watch it. Is there one that ends soon here that we could watch until it runs out? Okay, here's a game. Something's happening. Both players are in time trouble. Byo-Yomi's 15 seconds. They got like 30 Byo-Yomi's. Okay. Black to move and win. White to move and live in co. Good luck. Man. So, yeah, now something's happening here. What it is ain't exactly clear. There's a man with a stone over there. Now tell me, I gotta look out for these Ataris. So, how do you even estimate this? Also, wouldn't it be cool if I could watch these games through the Ancient Go interface? With the calming music in the background and the score estimator and. Oh. Black has paused the clock. Black is winning. Okay. Glad we got that figured out somehow. It's unfortunate I can't increase the board size because I see game pause down here. I'd actually like to see the board as large as possible, if that's okay with the people who made this interface. There's no button for full screen the board. Oh, that kind of works though. Wait, where's the estimator? There's an estimator. White by 7.5. See? White's totally winning this, maybe. So yeah, the question is, does Black live down there? Interface says no. Wait, can I back to game? So 1, 2, 3 kills the white. But I get the sense that Black dies much faster. Yeah, 'cause like 1, 2, and Black is dead. No, I'm sorry, 1, 2, 3. I mean, so it said white by 7.5, right? So, it is curious if you say Leela thinks she's losing this. So I wonder why the game is still stalled if one of the players is a computer, Leela. What's the issue? Leela says it's losing most of the time. Yeah. 30%. Things are starting to trend upward. Wonder why Leela's so pessimistic though. Black just paused to take. Oh, right. Right. Yeah, no, Black could certainly take a break against a computer. It's not. I mean, in theory, Black could even say, oh, I'm gonna spend this break thinking. And just try to come up with a way to win this, but that's not how games work when you're playing against a computer. You don't just find some sudden brilliancy that overturns the entire evaluation. On the other hand, it's curious that Leela thinks it's losing. Yes, this is the Alpha Goat. No, it's not. No. No, Google acquired DeepMind, research group. Yeah. Maybe White's just dead on the right. So we're talking about this over here? So, I mean, yeah, according to our silly estimator, White's totally living over here. White's totally fine. Don't worry about it. And obviously, this is just an estimate. So, yeah, in the lower left, Black is dead. I can see this territory belongs to White. This Black might be able to reduce a little bit. This up here, White. Yeah, that looks reasonable-ish. But you're saying maybe something over here is not quite working. Founder of DeepMind was a grandmaster at 15, you say? I mean, yeah, the most of these estimates seem plausible. And obviously, the point of the estimate isn't to tell the player the exact evaluation according to the most perfect engine. It's just to provide a generic estimate as to what's going on. Black also has the upper right-hand corner, which isn't being counted. Don't know, I find these estimates generally are pretty good. All right, we're back. We're gonna see, can Black win this? Oh, what's going on? Oh, yeah, no, I guess Black's doing good there. There's eye number one. I was gonna say, like, surely the press would have noticed if the DeepMind founder were a grandmaster. Now, I don't question that he's some sort of master. I don't question that. A grandmaster is a very special title in chess. Okay, so White reduces the corner. See, most of these moves look pretty sane, especially compared to my moves. Oh no. That's no good that the press lied to you. All right, so what's the computer evaluation? It's trending up toward 40%. Yeah, I'm sure the closer we get to the end game, the more that Leela's gonna nickel and dime its opponent for a space here, a stone there. Grandfather versus candidate father. Wow. That's quite the analogy you got there. Also, I apologize for the green background and blue text. If I could fix that, I would. It's absolutely horrifying. So I'll rely on you guys to read out the scores because I can't fix that while I'm streaming this. It'd take me too long to figure it out. But yeah, at least both players are of the consensus that it's a close game. I I missed. Did something happen in the lower left that made E1 necessary, or are we just at the point where players are trying to find the biggest moves on the board? Okay, so Leela switched to 50% or greater. So now it thinks it's winning. Oh. Did not realize that the players were this lopsided. I wonder if this was a handicap game. Because, in general, a 5 Don versus a 1 Q sounds like a pretty predictable. Okay. Okay, so it was an even game of 5 stones. That's cool. A 10 Don bot. I don't think any professional association is ever going to award a 10 Don rank. If I had to guess. Yeah, it'd be fun to watch more of these Leela games. Although, even more fun if like they came up with an inferior version of Leela that makes silly blunders. Oh, theme park. Nice. Did not know that. A while ago, I played Theme Hospital on stream and achieved an ending that I never achieved before. So that was special. Oh. There's a tournament in Japan called Judon. Did not know that. That's pretty cool. Well, it's looking like. Whoa, wait. Wait. I'm confused by that move. Does Black have another eye? I hope so. Where's that group going? I see one eye in that group. That could be bad news if he doesn't find another eye. Like, what prevents White from playing J6? Wait, Black? Black has two eyes on this group. Where, I see eye number one. Oh, I'm sorry, I forgot about this here. Okay, yeah, no, he easily makes the second eye somewhere down here. Never mind. Yeah, I'm kind of not good at counting liberties. No, I thought White was totally living down here, because I just saw a ton of white stones here, a ton of here. Like, no, that's not even close. That said, White still wins. So, go machines. Oh, that's another thing. I could play a handicap game against Leela. Or probably against a much inferior bot and still lose, but I don't know. It could be fun. I should try that sometime. Nah, AlphaGo lost a game. An 11 Don would be able to like simultaneously take on all the 9 Dons in the world. And, I don't know, play Quake or Doom or something at the same time. Yeah, I don't know. Like, I think for anybody to get that kind of title, they would need to keep up a sustained performance in the public eye. I mean, yeah, it could be 11 Don, but I mean, what kind of organization's gonna award 11 Don based on 5 games? So, that's cool. So, what was the turning point? No, it's just like, as I said, each little mistake is gonna cost a little bit, and eventually it adds up. That's kind of beautiful in a way that you don't necessarily see in chess. Where in chess, a player blunders a rook and might as well set up the game again. In Go, a lot of decisions add up, and then at the end, it's decided who played better, or who at least had the better result. So. Anywho, yeah, like I said, it's been an interesting session. I have to come back and play some more of this sometime, but I have other games in the queue. So, come this weekend, look forward to that. In the meantime, yeah, thanks for watching. Thanks for advice, really. Because, eventually over time, I'm sure I'll absorb enough of it to be not a complete beginner at the game. So, yeah. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.